Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself, he narrates in the Sahih Hadith, he says, when I was young, and again, we're talking about a time period when he's around 12, 13, 14 years of age. He says, I heard about what weddings were. Like the Quraysh, their weddings were filled with a lot of haram. And because they didn't know it to be haram. So they would have poetry that was vulgar. If you ever, and you read the poetry of Jahiliyyah, of the pre-Islamic era, it's actually very vulgar. And they have really harsh disses. I'm not kidding. I studied Alfiya ibn Malik with the Sharh ibn Aqil. And in the Sharh ibn Aqil, they mention a lot of this. They talk about people's moms like you wouldn't believe. You know, they talk about people's women, and it was very harsh. So in the weddings, they would have this poetry that was very lewd. And they would have women dance and men. And unfortunately, we see a lot of this even in the weddings today in the Muslim Ummah. A lot of haram. So they had the same thing at the time. So the Prophet ﷺ, before Nabuwah, one day he said, I want to go see what it's like. You know, he was curious, he was young. So he told one of the other shepherds, he goes, watch my flock this day, and I'm going to go and I'm going to attend the wedding. He didn't know haram and halal, it's before Nabuwah. He said, but when I went to enter, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caused me to fall asleep that I didn't see anything of it, and I didn't wake up until the ray of the sun hit me. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protected the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam from this. Now imagine this. This is when? Before Nabuwah. If the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went and sat and listened to the music and drank alcohol, would it be a sin? No. There is no halal haram here yet. But even then, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protected him. Now, what happened to us? Are we Muslim today? We're Muslim? You guys asleep? Don't make takfir on yourselves here. Are we Muslim? Do we know halal and haram? Is music and dancing and mixing and weddings halal or haram? Why do we do it? Why do we put up with it? Why is it that even the most religious of people, unfortunately, in such a structure that has developed in our society, that they fall? Whatever in the past is a past, let's change. Let's make a commitment. If there is music and dancing and mixing, I'm not coming. Tell your family, I'm not coming. That's it. Make a commitment so that inshallah this can change. We can make a stand. Be leaders in this. Don't put up with it.